So amazing, so amazing, so amazing, it's amazing, so amazing, so amazing, so
amazing. Front side, system one, back
up. Yeah. Still stepping it in, right?
Yeah, no, back side, we got the post.
All right. I'm always focused, I'm thinking of ways to be a better student athlete. My football abilities would earn me a full scholarship, but when the opportunity to play basketball presented itself, it was something that I couldn't turn down.
I think Mike Jones doing a good job, you know, especially being in college, it's different from high school. But in college, you know, you gotta worry about school then. You know, you get the season very long. You could get banged up with a lot of injuries.
It's about 8:30, 8:40 right now. And I got a class to run to later on, about an hour or so. So I try to squeeze that in because I know any time in the afternoon and the evening time, I'm going to be tired of basketball. So I just get with Joe Webb, and he real good at finding good times for me.
Webb back up. No!
If I can't, what are you doing? Yes.
I'm about to go to class, man. I'm gonna holler at y'all later.
I think Mike Jones is a very fine young man. He's hard-working young man, very honest, trustworthy guy that's very dependable, that, you know, we're extremely excited and happy that he's on our football team. And I think there's one thing about Mike, you can count on him to do what he says he's going to do.
A little better.
Yep. These my rainy day gloves.
A little skateboard
just in case. Oh yeah, I got the remote to the TV too, don't nobody know I got
yes,
that.
Sir. That's 100% Hollywood. Oh, look, check out the watch.
Man.
Check out the watch. Both watches have time. His just has a date. It just says
Thursday.
I
got the time.
I play two sports in college, basketball and baseball. But those two, they overlap just a little bit. And I know how difficult it was when you went to postseason from a basketball standpoint. And then baseball was already going, so you had to kind of get caught up. For him to do what he's doing, well, from an athletic standpoint, and maybe more importantly, balancing the academic piece with those two things, and then the two sports and an academic, that really speaks volumes about the discipline that you have to have as an athlete and as a student. And also, I think it speaks volumes as to his commitment to being the best at both things, or at all three things that he's trying to get accomplished.
Hey.
Come ahead and pick up something to eat.
I wish I could come in.
My day.
Look at you.
Hey, what's the name of that?
This man, Mike Jones, all around sports. Football, basketball, technician. Now, it got me the technician.
You gave me that nickname.
Because his routes are so superb on the field.
I think it's great, number one, that you've got coaches at a school that get along well enough, communicate well enough, everybody seems to be on the same page, that you'd be willing to share an athlete like that. And I think Coach Callaway deserves a lot of credit for being willing and generous to loan Coach Davis a player.
He's been a welcome addition, he really has. He's fit right in. Lost some players, the guys were the first ones to come to us and say, how about Mike Jones? Want to give Mike Jones a call? We weren't sure, but Coach Davis checked with Coach Callaway. He did a wonderful job. Coach was a big-time team player with that. We appreciate that.
My guy. What you mean? My guy. It's my guy.
He was hooping us this summer. We was like, Mike, come hoop with us. And every day, faithful, man, her ball. And somebody showing what he got. You know what I'm saying? I always knew he had it because, you know what I'm saying, he was all state in Tennessee.
I talked to Mike about wanting to play basketball, and I really think it's a very strong tribute to him and his character to wanting to help our basketball team.
I got a call from Coach Callaway. It was about an 8-something. And the first thing he started talking to me was about my grades. And that's how he always about grades.
Coach David really took a look at it because he liked him from the summer. I mean, he wanted to come out, you know what I'm saying, walk on when the football season was over.
And he's got to fit in with the chemistry of the rest of the group. And he's done a terrific job of doing that. He's very much a part of this basketball team and what we're doing and what we're trying to do and where we're trying to go. I think Mike's playing a vital role in that.
Knowing what's a good shot to take and taking it is different. You know, some people won't shoot. Be wide open, pass the ball, dribble. You know what I'm saying? They won't shoot. This guy, he's getting them up.
Every chance.
He wide open, you standing in the paint, he wide, he getting them up. You closing out, and you don't get there before the ball in there, it's up. It's up and gone.
Coach Davis pretty much said, I mean,
he said take a wide open shot, so, I mean, you can't fault him for it. Said Butler, and we was doing a closeout drill. Aaron throws the ball. AJ throws the ball. Mike runs and grabs the ball. Tucks the ball.
He clowns now.
Boom! Run AJ off. Turns the corner and he's still going, but this time he's dribbling as he's turning. Mike really ran AJ over.
Now, when I got the ball, I took it, and AJ's small, so he slid in front of me, and all I had was this side of my body, and I did run him over, but.
It looked like this now with the basketball.
But I dribbled though.
He took off. I was like, whoa, football, baby.
It's hard for a guy who's been with us since September and October to make an adjustment from the bench to playing more time. So think about a guy who's in a completely different sport, wasn't really looking at playing basketball, and he comes in the middle of what we're doing, and he's got to pick up everything. He's got to get in basketball shape.